They're playing like champions. They're really sucking it up and getting after it tonight against the Calgary Flames in a tough place. They lead 2-0 after one on goals by Wayne Gretzky and also Craig McTavish. Meanwhile, at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, the Leafs have just scored on the power play by Brad Smith, but they still trail the St. Louis Blues 6-4 in the third period. But St. Louis is going on the power play. Let's go up to the Gardens and check it out with Bob Cole and John Davidson.
Norwood shot. Here's Eddie Beers on top of the play. The Blues lead by 2 goals here in Toronto. Nearing the halfway mark of the third period, and they're on the power play now. By the Leafs, 2 of them are coming out of the zone. Burgess up the center, and Dan Dowell is up there with him. Burgess trying to pass to Dowell, but failed to do it. 2-2 tie after one period. The Blues own the second, and they're in again now here in the third. Leading by 2 goals, Hunter. A pass to Natras. This is the power play, St. Louis. Leafs set up a four-man box for their goal. Center set, and down in front of Reggett, the defenseman, Bill Root, to hang on to it. It was 4-3 at the end of the second period for St. Louis. Then Gilmore and Mahar score, but Smith here in the third, a goal for the Maple Leafs, and it's 6-4 now.
Now watch this. Bill Root loses his stick when he checks Eddie Beers to the right of Ken Reggett, the goaltender. Watch that action in front. Now he's going to come back without his stick and block the shot as Beers falls down with Bill Root's stick. Now Bill Root has to time this perfectly. He gets it up high, then gathers it in as the Maple Leafs are killing a penalty. St. Louis are 1-for-3 on the power play in this game. St. Louis never had a power play during that entire second period.
St. Louis, Gilmore also a shorthanded goal in this hockey game. That's looking very large right now. Here's Gilmore with the puck. A shot by Ramage is picked out. Cardinal fell, creating an opening for the St. Louis Blues. Pasloski got it back to the blue line. Here's Ramage again. Played into Pasloski. He couldn't control the bell. Shot stopped by Reagan. LaValle in the corner. Again at the blue line. Great pressure now by St. Louis. Looking for another 3-goal lead. It's passed into the corner again. Bell slapped at it. It comes in front. The Leafs try to get it out. They fail. Ramage at the blue line. Ramage dumped it off in behind the net. That is Salming. A chance to clear it. Does. Goes down the ice. Look at Millen racing out of the net. He's 30 feet out of the net.
Bob Salming had 23 minutes of ice time during the first two periods, and he's played a lot here in the third as his team trails by 2 goals.
Salming pitching in. Good play by Salming, giving it to Cortno. Cortno tried to play it back to him and did. Salming wrapped at it. The Blues now get it out of the zone. Three of them skating to center, led by Reeves. He played it into LaValle, who got it back, and Gilmore has to circle. 8 seconds left in the late penalty, and the Blues are offside. And Salming and Norwood collide at the blue line.
Some action at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto with the Leafs trailing the Blues 6-4. St. Louis looking to regain that home ice advantage. We'll be back with more on our road to the Cup in just a moment. The next game between Calgary and Edmonton will go into overtime. Edmonton is leading on a couple of goals by Craig McTavish and Wayne Gretzky, 2-0 after the first period. But last night we had two overtime games, one of them seen live on ESPN, and one of them was played at the Hartford Civic Center, the Adams Division Final between the Whalers and Montreal.
Another capacity crowd on hand last night in Hartford. Game 4 of the Adams Division Finals. The Hartford Whalers and the Montreal Canadiens. Steve Weeks, the man in the hot spot, replacing the injured Mike Leod in goal for Hartford. And early on, Weeks had more to worry about than just the Montreal Canadiens. Watch now as Weeks is concentrating on the puck. Whoa, here comes the net over backwards. One goalie caught in the net. Fortunately, no one was hurt. But Montreal was hurt on this play. Sylvain Turgeon, the shot, it just won't go over, but Stu Gavin knocks the puck into the net, and the home folks love it as Hartford leads 1-0 in the first. From there on, it became a defensive struggle. Steve Weeks losing his goal stick, so Ole Samuelson comes up big. The Hartford defenseman gets the puck out of harm's way, and we go on from there. Into the third period, Hartford still clinging to a 1-0 lead. Montreal on the power play. Big pileup in front of Weeks. Here comes the loose puck. There goes the goal by Matt Staslin. We're tied at 1, and we go into overtime. But it took only 1 minute and 7 seconds in the overtime to decide it in favor of the hometown Hartford Whalers, who needed this game. Kevin Dineen skates around. Veteran defenseman Larry Robinson shoots and scores, beating Patrick Roy high to the glove side. The Whalers, the whole team comes off the bench. This club made the playoffs on the next to the last night of the season. They've now forced at least a 6-game series for the mighty Montreal Canadiens. The series tied at 2-2.
And meanwhile, last night, another sellout crowd at Madison Square Garden where the Rangers led the NHL in attendance this year, and they'll come back for Game 6 because the Rangers forged a 2-2 tie in this best-of-seven series with Washington. That game also went to overtime with a former Ivy League hockey player providing the excitement.
Madison Square Garden in New York, another sellout crowd for Game 4 between the Rangers and Caps. The Rangers needed this one badly to even the series at 2. Early on, they score first. Pierre LaRouche to Will Paymon, and the Broadway Blues are on top. But the Capitals come back to tie it and then go ahead. Alan Hallward gets pulled down but still gets the puck to Kevin Hatcher. Young defenseman shoots. Van Beesbrouck gets most of it but not all of it. Washington led 2-1. The Caps will then add to their lead. Scott Stevens at the blue line slaps one in. The save by Van Beesbrouck of the Rangers, but Bobby Carpenter is on the doorstep for the rebound. The Capitals lead it 3-1 and one. The Rangers cut it to one, and then they get the equalizer in the second period. Tomas Sandstrom off the board, shoots and scores, and we're tied at 3, and the crowd is deafening in New York. The Caps then take a 4-3 lead. Bobby Gould with a wide slapper. Gaetan Duchesne gets it. Nice pass to Greg Smith, who shoots, and Washington is on top by 2 again, 5-3. But the Rangers get a quick one, and with less than 3 minutes to go with the score 5-4, make it 5-5 as Bob Brooks ties it up, and we go into overtime in this game as well. The puck is in the Washington zone in overtime. The Caps can't clear, and that's bad news. Bobby Brooks shoots and scores off Pete Peters. The Rangers even the series at 2 games apiece, going to Washington.
You know, it's amazing. We hang there tonight. We came back, tied the game. They scored with 1 minute left in the third period. We had a power play, and then I think the Huber scored and made it 5-4, and then Bobby scored, and he scored in overtime. It's just, it's outstanding.
You know, everybody's calling this magic. I say it's a lot of hard work. I mean, if that's not hard work and determination, I don't know another example of it. I feel that we showed a tremendous lot of character, and if you want to call it magic or not, I think it's character.
So will Bobby Brooks, the kid out of Yale, be the hero tomorrow night? We'll see. You'll see Game 5, the Rangers at Washington tomorrow night live on ESPN. 8 Eastern time, that'll be blacked out in the New York and Washington areas. And Saturday night, no blackout again. We'll be in Edmonton for Game 5 of this series, the Smythe Division Finals, the Calgary Flames and the Edmonton Oilers. Oilers leading Game 4 tonight live on ESPN, 2-0. In Eastern Canada, hockey is Montreal against Quebec. In the New York City area, it's the Rangers against the Islanders. In New England, it's the Boston Bruins and the Hartford Whalers. There are several great rivalries in the NHL, but none more intense than the one you're seeing tonight, the Battle of Alberta, the uncivil war between Calgary and Edmonton.